Good morning, students. Now, in the next part of the work is energy. We have studied what is power and what is a work done and the types of energies like the kinetic energy and the potential energy. Now, continue with the power. We have studied that in power, we know that power is equal to work done upon time. The rate of doing work is called the power, and the SI unit of power is watt. So, the bigger units of the power can be we can use are the kilowatts and the megawatts. Okay, we have already study all these things. The numericals based on the power. Now, the commercial unit of energy. Now, the commercial unit of energy. Commercial unit of energy. So, what is a commercial unit of energy? You know, the energy has a unit, joules. But this energy, this unit is very small quantity. It means it's representative. It can this joules is a very small unit of the energy. So for the bigger units, if we want to show the higher values of energy, then we have to use the bigger unit of energy. So the bigger unit of energy that we use for the commercial purpose is kilo watt hour. That is kilo watt hour. You know, power is equal to work done upon time. Or for the commercial purpose, we can also say that power is equal to energy consumed upon time. It means energy consumed should be equal to power multiplied by the time. This is energy consumed. And according to this formula, what should be the units of this energy? It should be watt into second. Since the SI unit of power is equal to watt at the time for is second. So we can say the SI unit of energy is watt second. And this watt second is actually equal to the joule. Okay. So this is a very small unit. If we use this unit for the commercial purpose, we have to use, we have to write the large values, large numerical values. So for the commercial purpose, we use the bigger unit, that is kilowatt hour. Since you know that the energy consumed will be equal to the power multiplied by the time. So joule is also equal to the watt into the second. If we represent the power into the kilowatt and time into the hours, so what should be the unit of this energy consumed? It will be kilowatt and hour. And this is a bigger unit of energy consumed. And there's a relation between the kilowatt hour and a joule. So first of all, we should know that the commercial unit of energy is kilowatt hour. So for the large quantities, we use this unit. For the commercial purpose, we use this unit. And now what is the relation between the kilowatt hour and joule? So you can write the commercial unit of energy is kilowatt hour. Okay. Now write down the relation between the kilowatt hour and the joule. Kilowatt R. So is it clear to you that watt second is equal to joule? Okay, so we can also write the unit of energy is watt second. So same as for the energy of unit is watt, kilowatt and R. So 1 watt second is equal to 1 joule. So we can find the relation between the kilowatt and the joule. 1 kilowatt is equal to 1000 watts. And 1 hour is equal to how much second? 60 into 60 seconds. Okay, so it will be 3, 6 and 50 watt second. Or if we write it in a standard form, then we can also write it like 3.6 into 10 to the power 6 watt second. Or we know that watt second also can be represented by using joules. So we can say that 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 3.6 times power 6 joule. It means a large quantity can be represented by 1 kilowatt hour only. So for the commercial purpose, we use this unit. And if you want to define the 1 kilowatt hour, so you can define it like this. That 1 kilowatt hour, definition of 1 kilowatt hour. This is the definition. So you can write 1 kilowatt hour of electrical energy is commonly known as, okay, this is not the definition, known as one unit of energy. Or for the 1 kilowatt hour, we can say that if an appliance of power 1 kilowatt is used for 1 hour, we can say the energy consumed by the appliances is 1 kilowatt hour. So you can write it like this: if an appliances having power 1 kilowatt is used for 1 hour, we can say the energy consumed by the appliances 1 kilowatt hour. Okay, so like a heater, generally we have a heater which has the power of 1 kilowatt, which can have the power of 1 kilowatt, and if we use this appliance, means the heater, for 1 hour, then the energy consumed by this heater in 1 hour will be 1 kilowatt hour. We also represent it by using the value unit. We also write it like a one unit. 1 kilowatt hour means 1 unit. आपने जनरली सुना होगा, जैसे घर में बोलते हैं ना कि 200 यूनिट का बिजली इस बार आई है, 200 यूनिट हमने इस बार खर्च की है. तो व्हाट इज़ द मीनिंग ऑफ यूनिट? यूनिट का मतलब कि आप घर में कितनी बिजली आप यूज़ कर रहे हैं, एनर्जी कितनी कंज्यूम कर रहे हैं. सो यूनिट इज किलो वाट आर. ओके, देयर आर सम न्यूमेरिकल्स बेस्ड ऑन द कॉमर्शियल यूनिट ऑफ एनर्जी, दैट इज किलो वाट आर. वन इज अ रेडियो सेट. यू कैन राइट द न्यूमेरिकल विद मी, इट विल बी रियली हेल्पफुल टू यू to understand the numericals. 60 watt, this is a radio set having the power of 60 watt. You know, all the appliances have the power, they work on certain voltage. 60 watt runs for 50 hours. You know, जैसे घर में बोलते हैं ना, जितना ज़्यादा पावर आप यूज़ करें, जितने पावर का आप अप्लाइंस यूज़ करते हो, उतनी ज़्यादा एनर्जी कंज्यूम होती है. तो इट मीन्स एनर्जी कंज, एक्चुअली वी नो डैट एनर्जी कंज्यूम डिपेंड ऑन द पावर. तो बाय इंक्रीजिंग द पावर, द एनर्जी कंज्यूम इज ऑल्सो इंक्रीजेस. इफ यू आर यूजिंग द ए सी हैज अ रियली हाई पावर. सो दे हैव द हाई पावर, इट मीन्स द एनर्जी कंज्यूम बाय द ए सी इज सो हाई एज कम्पेयर टू द फैन. फैन हैज अ वेरी लो पावर, सो द एनर्जी कंज्यूम बाय द फैंस आर रियली सो लेस. सो इट मीन्स द एनर्जी कंज्यूम डिपेंड एक्चुअली ऑन द पावर. Okay, now the radius of 60 volt runs for 50 hours. How many unit? Unit means kilowatt hour. Okay, how many unit of electric energy are consumed? Okay. So for this numerical, first of all we have to write it, what are the values which is given in the question. We are given the power. What is the power? This is 60 watt. If you want to find the energy consumed in kilowatt hour, or we can say in unit, we have to convert the power into kilowatt. Okay, so first of all, convert the power into kilowatt by dividing it by 1000. So by dividing it by 1000, we convert it into the kilowatt. So this is a power, and we are using this radio set for the 50 hours. So the time is equal to 50 hours. Since it is already in hours, so we don't need to change it in any other unit. So energy consumed, we know that energy consumed is equal to power multiplied the time. According to the formula, that's, we know that power is equal to energy consumed upon time. So we can say that energy consumed will be power multiplied the time. Okay, according to this formula, we can say that energy consumed is equal to power multiplied by the time. Now what is the value of power? Power is equal to 60 upon 1000 kilowatt, and time is 50 hours. So we can cancel this 0, 5 2s are 10, and 2 3s are 6. Okay, it means 3 unit, or we can say kilowatt hour. Okay, this is the energy consumed by this radio set in 50 hours. Now more numericals which are based on the power, energy control. Second question. A family uses 50 units of electrical energy. A family uses 250 units of electrical energy during a month. So what is given in the question? It is given that how much energy are you consuming, the family is consuming. Calculate this energy in joule. Okay, it's very easy. This energy in joules. Okay, for the question, we know that energy consumed is equal to 250 units, or we can say 250 kilowatt hour. So we have write the relation between the kilowatt hour and the joule, and we can use this relation. Like, we know that 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 3.6 times power 6 joules. So by multiplying it with 3.6 into 10 power 6 joules, we can find the value of energy consumed in joules. So after multiplying, we will find it like 3.6. It will be approx 900 times power 6 joule. Okay, so this is the energy consumed, not the 6. It will be, after multiplying, it will become 8. So 900 times power 8 joule of energy will be consumed by the family. Okay, now the transformation of energy. You know, energy is conserved in the universe. It only can change in from one form to another form. It we can't destroy it. It cannot be created. It cannot be destroyed. But it can be changed from one form to another form. So this is called the transformation of energy. Energy is always transferred from one form to another form. The total energy in this universe is always constant. So transformation of energy. Transformation of energy. Okay. Transformation of energy means energy can be changed from one form to another form. So you can write the definition. The change of one form of energy. The change of one form of energy into another form of energy is known as transformation of energy. Okay, so for example, if you are dropping a stone from the height, okay, sorry, I don't see what is here in the camera. Dekha nahi maine, dikh nahi raha tha, sorry for that. Suppose you are releasing a stone from the height. You are here on the terrace and you are releasing a stone. So for this stone, if you release this stone, you know that the stone which is at the height, at that certain height, has some energy, which is in the form of potential energy. So it means this stone has the energy that is called the potential energy in it. So when you release this stone, initially it has a potential energy. Before releasing this stone don't have any kinetic energy. It has only the potential energy. Okay. Now it start falling in downward direction towards the ground. What happens? You know that kinetic energy, the energy of this stone is going to be increases. Its velocity going to be increases. यहाँ पे कुछ velocity नहीं है, जैसे आपने drop किया, it's had a zero velocity. जैसे ही नीचे जाता जाएगा, इसकी velocity increase होती जाती है. तभी तो ऐसा होता है ना, जितनी ज़्यादा आप height से फेंकते हैं, उतना ज़्यादा ही इसकी velocity नीचे तक पहुँचते-पहुँचते हो जाती है. So when you release it from the terrace, this stone has the energy in the form of potential energy. When it start falling in downward direction, its velocity going to be increases. Its velocity going to be increases means its kinetic energy is going to be increases. We know that the moving object has energy in the form of kinetic energy. So it means it is, when it is falling in downward direction, its kinetic energy is going to be increases. Its kinetic energy is increases now. So at this point, when it just reached the ground, it has the highest kinetic energy. And how much energy will it have? It will have the same energy as it has when it is at the height. Means जितनी energy इसके पास यहाँ पे थी उतनी energy इसके पास यहाँ होती है, but the form of energy is different. It means the energy it has at this height is potential energy, but the energy when it just reaches the ground has only the kinetic energy. It has only the kinetic energy, not the potential energy. So where is this potential energy is gone, and from where this kinetic energy comes? This potential energy actually is going to be changed in the kinetic energy when it falls in downward direction. So energy can be changed from one form to another. We can't say the energy can be destroyed or it can be created, but it can be converted. It is always converted from one form to another form. So in this example, in which we fall a stone from the height, the potential energy is going to be converted into the kinetic energy. At the particular height, it has only the potential energy, but when just it reached the ground, it has only the kinetic energy, no any potential energy. So this is the only example, this is not the only example of the transformation of energy. There's a lots of example for the transformation of energy. What happens if you throw a stone in a vertically upward direction? What will happen? Actually when you throw a stone in upward direction, what will happen? You have to give some velocity to it. Hai na, kuch velocity deke fekoge. और इट्स वेरी क्लियर कि जितनी ज़्यादा वेलोसिटी देख के फेंकोगे उतनी ज़्यादा हाइट पे जाएगा, है ना? ये बात बहुत क्लियर से समझ में आती है हमें कि वी गेट गिव इट अ हाई एनर्जी, इट विल अटेन द हाईएस्ट वेलोसिटी, और इफ वी गिव अ लेस वेलोसिटी, इट विल अटेन ओनली द लेस हाइट. सो इट मीन्स इफ वी गिव इट द सम वेलोसिटी, इट मीन्स वी आर गिविंग अ काइनेटिक एनर्जी टू दिस स्टोन. द वर्क डन which is done by us on this stone is stored in the form of kinetic energy. So we throw in an upward direction, what happens? You are giving it a kinetic energy. What happens when it attain its maximum height at this height? Suppose this ball is going only to this height. Up to this height, now it has a zero velocity. You know, after this height, after attaining the maximum height, it start falling in downward direction. So at this height, its kinetic energy is zero. It don't have any velocity. Velocity is zero. Since velocity is zero, so we can say that kinetic energy is also zero. Since the kinetic energy is zero, so we can say that all the kinetic energy, where is gone? Where is all this kinetic energy is gone? Actually, when this stone is attaining a height, it will attain a potential energy. You know, the energy possessed by a body which is at a particular height has a potential, is a potential energy. So we can say when it is moving in upward direction, it is attaining a potential energy, and kinetic energy is going to be decreases. It means this kinetic energy changes into the potential energy when it thrown in upward direction, or at the maximum height, its all kinetic energy is going to change in potential energy. Now at this height, it has only the potential energy without any kinetic energy, and this all kinetic energy is going to change in potential energy. और इसके आगे क्या होता है? Just like this. So this is the example of transformation of energy when we fall a stone from the height, or if we throw a stone in a vertically upward direction. Now the other examples. What happens at the hydroelectric power house? So I am writing here energy transformation at a hydroelectric powerhouse. You know what is a hydroelectric powerhouse? Where we use water for generating electricity, like in Tiri Dam. Tiri Dam is constructed to produce electricity. And since it is using a water, so we can say that it is a hydroelectric powerhouse. So what happens at hydroelectric powerhouse? Electric energy is also the form of energy. So from where we get this energy? Actually, when we store in dams, there is lots of water stored in the backside of the dam. You know, This water has a lot of energy, which is in the form of potential energy. Since this water is stored at the height, it means it has some energy, and this energy is in the form of potential energy. Now what happens? This water is allowed to fall in downward direction, and this water is actually falls on the turbines. Turbines is just like a fan, जैसे पंखे के blades होते हैं, just like a turbine. And this turbine is connected with a shaft, and this shaft is connected with a generator. Generator means which generate electricity. So what happens at the hydroelectric powerhouse? We store some water to the particular height. When this water is allowed to fall on this turbine, what happens? This potential energy is going to be changed in kinetic energy. आप एक height से पानी को नीचे गिरा रहे हो तो क्या हो रहा है? जो भी चीज़ चल रही है उसमें क्या है? Velocity है, which is the kinetic energy. So according to this, now if we are going to fall this water on the turbines, what we are doing? We are changing the potential energy into the kinetic energy. Now this falling water actually rotate this turbine. It means this kinetic energy changes into the mechanical energy, or we can also say the kinetic energy. We तो move कर रहे हैं, तो इसके पास भी kinetic energy है. So potential energy is change into the kinetic energy, or we can say the mechanical energy. And by this, when this turbines rotate, actually this shaft is also rotated. And by this rotation of this shaft, this generator can generate electricity. So what happens now? Now this kinetic energy is changing to the electrical energy. Electric energy. So what happens at the hydroelectric powerhouse? At hydroelectric powerhouse, actually the potential energy is changed into kinetic energy. And now the kinetic energy change into the electric energy. Okay, so we can say that energy can be transferred from one form to another form, like in the hydroelectric powerhouse. More examples for the transformation of energy. Now what happens at the thermal powerhouse? You know the thermal powerhouse? Okay, I'm just going to explain you. First I have to write it. Energy transformation at a thermal powerhouse. So first we should know what is a thermal powerhouse. Actually, if we are using the water at the hills, we can use this type of dams, like the dams we can construct at the particular height, so that these dams can store the water, and it can this water can be used to rotate the turbines. But what happens at the plains? Because it is not necessary that कि आपको सारे plains में जो है वो hills तो नहीं मिलने वाला है, तो कैसे आप पानी को गिराओगे नीचे? So for the plains, we use the thermal power house. What is thermal power house? Actually, in thermal power house, what we do? We heat the water by using some coal, some fuels like the coal. So suppose we are using the coal for heating this water. Okay, when this water is heated up to its boiling point, it's changing into the steam. Okay, you know, at the boiling point this water will change into the steam. Now this steam with the high pressure is allowed to force on the turbine. This steam is with a high pressure, we throw this steam on the turbines, and same just like this, it has a shaft, and shaft is connected to the generator. So what happens at the thermal powerhouse? When we are burning the coal, what we are doing? We are using the chemical energy. Coal has a chemical energy. You know, coal is made up of carbon, and if we burn the carbon produces a carbon dioxide as well as the heat. So we are changing the chemical energy. So this coal has a chemical energy, and we are using this chemical energy to convert the water into the steam. So what we are doing? We convert this chemical energy into the heat energy. Okay. So what we are doing? We are burning the coal. It means we are using the chemical energy. And since this coal heat this water and convert this water into the steam, it means this chemical energy is now going to change into the heat energy. And what we are doing with this steam? we are rotating the turbines. It means with this heat energy, we change this heat energy into the kinetic energy. So not we, what we are doing? We convert the heat energy into the kinetic energy. If this stream is falls on this turbine by high with a high pressure, what will happen? This turbine start to be rotating. So by rotation means it has some mechanical energy, or we can say it has a kinetic energy. Now this kinetic energy is now going to change into the electrical energy. When this turbine rotate, its shaft is also rotated. With this rotation, we can generate electricity by using the generator. So we can say kinetic energy is changing into the electrical energy now. Electrical energy. Okay, so these are some examples of the transformation of energy. What happens at a different level, how the energy changes from one form to another form. There's more different examples for the transformation of energy, like the electric motor. What happens at motors? Aap ghar pe mixi chalate hain, to mixi mein kya hota hai? You are using the electrical energy. And when the mixer grinder is rotated, it means this electric energy is going to change into the kinetic energy, or we can say the mechanical energy. So it means different forms of energy can be changed into the different forms, and we are changing this energy in different places. Like in electric bulb, what happens at the bulb? Bulb mein kya hota hai ki aapne jo hai, you are passing the electric current, and if you are passing the electric current, this electric current change into the heat energy and the light energy. So at every level you are changing the different forms of energy. It means you are transform the different forms of energy into the another one. Okay, these are the transformation of energy. Now next video we will study about different appliances which we use for changing the different forms of energy, and about the law of conservation of energy. Okay, that's all. Bye.